Good morning. Today we are going to discuss about electrical temperature measurement. So basically, in this chapter we are going to discuss about the cement industry. Specifically, we are going to analyze the blast furnace temperature. So for the blast furnace temperature measurement, we are going to use the different type of instruments. So before going to discuss about the blast furnace temperature measuring instrument, let us see the what are the types of electrical temperature measuring instruments. So basically different type of electrical temperature measuring instruments are used. They are classified into different types. They are resistance thermometer, thermocouple type, thermistor type, and thermopile. Here, resistance thermometer is a positive temperature coefficient. When the temperature increases, resistance is also increased. And thermistor is a negative temperature coefficient. When the temperature increases, that corresponding resistance is decreases. Thermocouple, which is also formed by the two dissimilar metals, whereas the hot junction and cold junction will be formed. And thermopile, number of thermocouples are connected, then it is considered as a thermopile. Now let us see the advantages and disadvantages of thermocouple, thermistor, and RTD. Then we are going to prefer that another type of instruments which are used in blast furnace temperature measurement. So that instruments are pyrometer. So before discuss those principles and operation of pyrometer, before that we have to see that what are the range of the instruments for temperature measuring instruments other than the pyrometer. So among these all temperature measuring instruments, RTD is also one of the important instrument. So this instrument having different advantages. This one having high accuracy. It is also used in wide range of temperature, like -200 to 650 degrees centigrade, and small in size, fast in response, good repeatability, and also temperature compensation is not required. Then at the same time here different disadvantages are also there. This temperature thermometer having resistance thermometer having high cost, bridge circuit is required for power supply, and also power supply is needed. Heating of resistance element and current through the grid circuit leads are inaccuracy, and mechanical abuse induced because of the vibrations. So large bulb size than the thermocouple, and these resistance thermometers are slow response time than the thermistor. Okay, then thermocouple which are formed with two dissimilar metals, whereas hot junction and cold junction temperature differences, based on that we are going to analyze that. If you take the thermocouple having some disadvantages. So it is capable of being used for the directly measuring temperature type of technique it is, and it is measuring up to 2600 degrees, and may also be brought into direct contact with the material being measured. And this one having high resolution, rugged in construction, and which is also more reliable. And the disadvantages of thermocouple. Basically, this thermocouple is a non-linear type, and this thermocouple having a complex operation, and two measurements are required. The calibration is also required for any time whenever we are use this instrument as a thermocouple for the temperature measurement, calibration must be required. So these are the disadvantages. Now when you take the thermistor also, it is different shapes of thermistors are available, rod type, bed type, disc type, but the temperature which starts from -60 to almost 160 or 120 degrees centigrade which is available, even though there is some sort of non-linear response will be produces from the analysis of thermistor, but these drawbacks are overcome with the pyrometer. This pyrometer which is also used for the blast furnace temperature measurement. So because that pyrometer will also be used without contact with the device, without contact with the material, or without contact with the surface, we are going to measure the temperature. So basically pyrometer means it is a Greek word, pyre and measurement, that is pyrometer. It is also one type of remote sensing type thermometer, and it is used to measure the temperature of surface. So this device is the one of the temperature measuring type of instrument by the thermal radiation. So a process which is known as a pyrometry, and also sometimes it is called as a radiometry. Okay, basically the pyrometers are classified into two types: radiation pyrometer and the optical pyrometer. Other than this, different types of pyrometers are available: quartz type thermometer, thermal solid state temperature measurement, optical fiber temperature measurement, and ultrasonic thermometers. Now let us see the types of optical pyrometer and radiation pyrometer. So basically this pyrometer will have a different contents, different internal parts. Optical system and the detector is very important. So the detector will give the give the output, and the lens system will be called as the optical system. It is used to focus the infrared energy naturally emitted by the object onto the sensor or a detector. Okay, so that sensor response is to infrared radiation, and that IR radiation energy is converted into electrical energy. So that electrical output signal of the detector can be displayed in terms of temperature. So we are going to measure that electrical output, electrical signal, into the correct temperature signal. Okay, so that is the basic pyrometer. And the optical pyrometer, which is also worked with the basic principle of J star is equals to sigma epsilon T power 4, but the sigma is the constant, proportional constant, and epsilon is Stefan Boltzmann constant, emissivity, temperature is T. Okay, so by using this principle, we are going to that optical pyrometers are working. Okay, so that output is used to infer the objects of temperature from the distance. So at some distance, we are going to measure the temperature. Without that measuring device, without contact with the material, we have to measure the temperature. So that is the special advantage of this pyrometer. So this pyrometry is a technique for determining the body's temperature by measuring its electromagnetic radiation itself. Okay, so basic types are optical pyrometer and radiation pyrometer. So now if we see the type of optical pyrometer principle, whereas three different cases are considered for this. In case one, we have to compare the temperature measuring source, temperature source, and the reference source. Okay, so these two temperatures are compared with each other, and the filament will be absorbed by the observer. So whenever these two temperature measuring source and reference source, these two will be equal, then the filament will be disappear. Whenever the reference temperature is hotter than the temperature source, then the brightness of this will be visible. Okay, here the lens helps in focusing the thermal radiation onto the reference bulb, and the observer watches the process through the eyepiece and correct it in such a manner that reference lamp filament has a sharp focus and the filament is superimposed on the temperature source image. So the radiation from the source is emitted, and the optical objective lens can be captured the light. Okay, so this is the generalized process of optical pyrometer. Once the observer starts to changing the rheostat values, and the current in the reference lamp changes. Okay, this is in turn changes its intensity. So So this change in current can be observed in three different ways. Here clearly observe that the observer start changing the rheostat values and the current in the reference lamp changes. So this will be termed the change in intensity. This will turn the change in intensity. So this change in current can be observed in three different ways. In the first case, filament is dark. Second case, filament is bright. Third case, filament is disappear. In the first case, whenever the filament is dark, at that case, reference temperature is cooler than the temperature source. And the filament is bright, that reference temperature is brighter than the temperature source. Whenever reference and temperature source both are equals with each other, that filament will be disappear. In the block diagram, we have mentioned. Okay, at the third case, the filament will be disappear. While consider these three cases, there is a equal brightness between the filament and temperature source. At this time, the filament will be disappear and the current that flows in the reference lamp that can be measured, as its value is a measure of the temperature of radiated light in the temperature source. So whenever that instrument is calibrated, the current flows in the reference lamp is measured. This value is a measure of the temperature of the radiated light in the temperature source. So this is the working of the optical pyrometer. Then advantages of optical pyrometer. It is a simple assembling of this device and easy to operate. And it is provide a very high accuracy, that is plus or minus 5 degrees Celsius. So there is no need of any direct body contact between optical pyrometer and the object. So this is the special advantage while compared with the other type of methods like a thermometer, resistance thermometer, thermocouple and thermistor, remaining. So that is the advantage. There is no direct contact between the optical pyrometer and object. So that is the advantages of pyrometer. Now, disadvantages are limitations of optical pyrometer. This device is not useful for obtaining continuous values of temperature at small interval of time. At particular interval of time, it will give some reading. So that is the one of the limitation. As the measurement is based on the light intensity, the device can be used only in applications with a minimum temperature of 700 degrees. And next one is radiation pyrometer. So this type of radiation pyrometer is very important, and these are also used in blast furnace temperature measurement. So mainly the radiation pyrometers is also used for the temperature measurement through the naturally emitted heat radiation by the body. So this heat is known to be a function of its temperature. So according to the application of the device, the way in which heat is measured can be summarized into two different methods. So that method, total radiation power pyrometer and selective radiation pyrometer. In this total radiation pyrometer, which can be measured the source, heated source, total heat emitted from the source, measuring with at all wavelengths. But selective radiation pyrometer, which can be measured the heat from the source measured at a given wavelength. So it is called as a selective radiation pyrometer. Okay, so this is the block diagram of selective radiation pyrometer, where hot object, lenses, mirrors and available different adjustable eyepieces will be there, and temperature will be displayed in the detector, where the detector will be receive the output signal, different radiation signals. Okay, so advantages and disadvantages of this radiation pyrometer. Basically, it is a simple assembly and accuracy is also plus or minus 5. No need of any direct contact with the body, and the device can be measured at very high temperatures. It can also be used to see the heat produced by the object or source. And the main disadvantages, it is not useful for obtaining continuous values of temperature and only useful for measuring the very high temperatures. Normal low range of the temperatures, which radiation type of pyrometers are not so, and higher cost as compared to conventional thermocouple. And advanced radiation thermometers are involved to extra complicated design and optics. Okay, so these are the different method of pyrometers. especially radiation parameters are used in blast furnace temperature measurement. Okay, then in the last chapter we have briefly discussed about the flow measurement. In this flow measurement, especially for the paper and pulp industry, that rotameter, cylinder and piston type flow meters are used. Basically, the flow meters are classified into different types as variable area. Under variable area, we have to consider one of the important flow meter as a rotameter, cylinder and piston type flow meter. Other than that, tapered tube flow meter, float type flow meter. Okay, so these are very important. We will discuss